The man at the center of a federal investigation into tomato price fixing, Scott Salyer, is behind bars tonight. He was taken into custody today at JFK in New York. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen has the story live from our Salinas newsroom.
Well, Dan, Scott Salyer was arrested today in New York City after getting off a flight coming back into the country from London. He was returning to the country after being gone since October of last year. Now, Salyer is charged with 20 counts of mail and wire fraud connected with what's being called a scheme to defraud SK Foods corporate customers. Those include Kraft Foods, Frito-Lay, and Safeway, to make sure that those customers bought from SK Foods and bought at above market prices. Prosecutors say that Salyer also okayed the sale of tomato products with mold levels higher than levels approved by the USDA. Now, last year, Salyer sat down with Action News. We asked him if he could see a light at the end of the tunnel.
Absolutely, because good people will prevail. And we will have businesses going forward in the future. We're going to, you know, we're loyal to ourselves, loyal to the banks, loyal to our suppliers and growers.
That, of course, as he was in the midst of bankruptcy and his companies facing closure. Now, the key person providing information to the feds right now is Salyer's former personal assistant, a woman named Jeannie Johnson, who is only referred to in the complaint as JJ. Thanks to information from her, federal authorities have been tracking Salyer's alleged efforts to move and hide money and obtain citizenship in a country that would not extradite him, including Uruguay and France. Now, Johnson has not been indicted, but four high-ranking corporate purchasing managers pleaded guilty to receiving bribes from SK Foods between January of 2008 and January of 2009. So as a former SK Foods broker, Dan Randy Rahal. Now, Salyer will make his first appearance in court in a federal court in New York City tomorrow.
All right. Thank you, Brittany. The complaint also says additional charges and searches could come in the near future. The maximum penalty on the mail and wire fraud charges is 20 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.